All right. Well, good afternoon, radio junkies. You're so fortunate to be tuned to 88.1 WMUC-FM in beautiful downtown College Park, the cultural mecca of Prince George's County. And DJ Drew is sexy. See, I was told to say that a little while ago. I was told, some drop I heard, something I heard.
If you say so, I... Yeah, I'm not going to argue and everything like that.
Well, you're the one that said so in the drop.
I did?
Yeah.
Oh well.
You know...
Don't make me do this.
You know, he... Don't make me... That's your answer for everything. I'm going to have your drops memorized. Where was I going with this? I don't remember.
I don't know. Somebody in drop told you to say to.
Yeah, somebody told me to say that.
Yeah.
You know?
I don't know.
Oh yeah, and for you guys out there, even though he says he's not. DJ Drew is sexy, so
he tries. He tries.
He is sexy. So good. There we go. We mystery solved. And it doesn't hurt to be in the same room with him. We'll put it that way.
Unless it's been like a couple days since my last shower, in which case it might hurt a little.
That's like anybody for that matter.
Yeah, no, nah, my brand is a little bit worse, but that's all right. I'm good today.
You eat a lot of garlic?
I hope I'm good today.
You eat a lot of garlic?
Yeah, I'm good today. No, I didn't eat a lot of garlic. I have?
Sniffing his pits there.
Yeah. Well, you got to make sure. You know, what did I have? Yeah. I haven't eaten anything today. Oh no, I had milk today.
You had milk?
Yeah, that's
good. Good man.
That's the breakfast of champions there. And I don't know. I haven't eaten a lot lately. Trying to slim down on the poundage, or just been too stressed and busy to eat.
I was going to say that you could just gain weight and just be a lot of sexy.
There you go.
See?
There you go. Yeah, I can do that. I can do the Chris Farley Chippendales. That's actually what I went for as Halloween.
Chris Farley Chippendales.
You've never seen the Chris Farley Chippendales?
No.
Oh, Saturday Night Live. Great sketch to any of you listeners out there in Radio Land.
See, that's my problem. I don't watch television.
There you go. Now, this one is worth watching. I mean, granted, it's television from, I think it was like 94 or something like that. So television these days. Yeah, no, I don't blame you.
So are they all threatening to do the full Monty or something?
No. What happens was there's an interview for a position at Chippendales. And it comes down to two people. The guest host, who was Patrick Swayze. Fresh off of the Dirty Dancing and all that other fun stuff.
Okay, so he's looking terrific. He's actually pretty fit.
Yeah,
He's also a very good dancer.
Yes.
By his own right.
Typical Patrick Swayze, you know. And the other person in the running for this job at Chippendales is Chris Farley. And his...
Don't know if I know Chris Farley.
Chris Farley, his typical physique. Chris Farley probably weighed about 320 pounds.
Oh, so fitting competition.
Yes.
For Patrick.
Yes, and this was down to the wire. They were the last two looking for this job and everything like that. And it really, according to the judges, it really was a tough competition. And so the two of them take.
I see you got a playlist started.
Yeah, yeah. There's
fill
nothing
it
on
out.
There. There's
fill
nothing
it out,
on
it. Fill it out. But I'm sorry to divert. But now what about Chris Farley?
Yeah, the competition between Chris Farley and Patrick Swayze, and it was a very tight competition according to the judges. They they just could not choose between the two of them. Which one of the two should be the Chippendales dancer? And so that's what I went as Halloween. I had the cuffs, on the wrists and everything.
Yeah.
I didn't have a boombox playing "Everyone's Working for the Weekend," but I probably should have.
Well, I haven't dressed up for Halloween in a very long time, and I went over to a friend of mine's house. I mean, his invite said costumes required, and I didn't have a costume, so I just went over. Yeah. But I had my overcoat on. So, I rolled up my sleeves, so my arms are bare, and I rolled up my pants so that, my legs are bare, and up to the point where the overcoat, so I walked in looking like...
You were about to flash somebody.
Yeah, I came dressed up as a flasher.
There you go.
So I walked in, and he said, where's your costume? I said, I'm in my costume. He said, what are you dressed up as? And I pointed down to my legs, and he's like, Oh, I got it.
Yeah, you got it. You gotta grab the coat like you're about to tear it off and say, and you just and say, "Do you really want to know?"
Yeah, and I was holding my coat, you know, like that. And
do you really want to see my costume?
Yeah, yeah. So anyway, I ended up I flashed, you know, everyone, and you know, and I flashed you know, the people who were by the doorway when I came in, and his sister said, he looked at me because I was fully clothed, and she just looked at me and said, "You can change in the other room."
Nice.
So that was the last time I dressed up in a Halloween, and I can't even remember how many decades ago that was.
Hmm. Well, you know,
probably sometime in the mid-80s, maybe.
Yeah, I've always been a very, you know, minimalistic kind of guy. For the last, you know, let's see, there were a couple of years as a teenager. You know, mm-hmm. I grew up playing guitar and everything like that. I just carried around my guitar case and you know, dressed as myself and told everybody I was an insane guitarist and, you know, give me some candy. And so that lasted from about, I must have been, you know, maybe 12, 13, 14 to last week.
I was going to say you get a lot of mileage out of it.
Yeah, up until the Chippendales thing, you know.
Were you going to enter the competition?
There was a competition. I went to.
Was there really?
Yeah. Actually, I went to. I went to an event called the Aloha Halloween show over here at the Fillmore Silver Spring with some bands that I know and play on my show.
Just recently.
Friday the 28th.
Oh, it was on Friday. Okay.
I believe it was. And that was hosted by, it was a show, it was a concert with Ballyhoo, Bumpin' Uglies, and Higher Education. Three great bands, all from the state of Maryland, who happen to be back here. They threw this big show, and actually the winner of the costume contest got free tickets to every event at the Fillmore Silver Spring for all of next calendar year.
Wow. Yeah. So all of 2017.
All of 2017, which also means that apparently my Chippendale sexiness was not good enough. I tried.
It wasn't.
So you know how you said, you know, DJ Drew is sexy? Apparently not.
Well, you know, not everybody would appreciate it.
Or not quite. I guess I'm just a 9, not a 10. I thought it was a 10.
Well, you could say not everybody would appreciate it, you know.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know.
Don't sell yourself short just because not everybody has good taste.
There you go, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what we'll chalk this up to.
Anyway, the I was commenting on the bass line. I'm not a big Beastie Boys fan. What song was that?
Yes, the last song there was a song called "Sabotage" off their album "Ill Communication." They got a pretty good bass line. There are a lot of. I like to think that I play a lot of bands with pretty solid bass lines. I do like the lower register. I feel that the bass and the drums are the backbone of a band, and so. I like it when they shine a little more.
That was a mean bass line that guy had. I must admit, you know, even though I'm not, you know, that much of a bassist, I'm not much of a. Pardon me, I shouldn't say that because the bottom end is my favorite end of any good band. I'm not a big Beastie Boys fan, but that guy's bass line was. It almost sounded like a fuzzed out guitar for a second. I'm listening to it. I said, "No way, man! He's just playing in the upper registers."
Yeah, well, it could have been. I don't know.
No, he was playing in the upper registers on the bass.
Yeah,
yeah. I got that by listening a little more attentively to make sure it wasn't a guitar.
Yeah,
the guitarist was probably walking with him at that point, but
yeah.
That was a mean bass line.
Yeah. Well, and I've always liked when one instrument can be. Confused for another, like for instance, when you hear a bass line and it may be a guitar, or when you hear a guitar and it may be a bass line, or something like that, or if you use any instrument percussively, you know, to double the drums.
Oh, absolutely! And what was it? The later, I guess, starting with Machine Head, and later was John Lord's, you know, John Lord's organ. Instead of plugging into the Leslie speaker he used to use in his earlier works. And he plugged it into a Marshall amp. He plugged it into a guitar amp.
Yeah.
And it was an interview or a DVD. I can't remember the name of it where he's interviewed. And he said, I played some of it one time and after his passing. And he said basically after he did that, he like unleashed a beast.
Well, you know, I'm a big, especially, you know, back in high school, I was a big metalhead, a big Metallica fan. And they described their original bassist, the bassist who appeared on their original album, Cliff Burton, as they heard this sound. And all they heard this wonderful guitar sound, and all they saw was a guy playing a bass and this red mop of hair as he was headbanging. And they said, all right, we got to get this guy in our band.
Wow. Not so bad.
Yeah. So, Dominic, how have you been this week?
I've been good. It's been a very busy week. I'm getting ready for planting, so I've got...
Oh, I thought maybe you were getting ready for, like, voting and stuff.
Voting, I'm really kind of trying to ignore that.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't really want to go down that road. Not a politics kind of guy.
Yeah, it's the first election right in my life where I don't like any of them.
Really? That's been all the elections for me. I don't like politicians.
Speaking of which,
I usually write in the write-in votes for like George Carlin.
Where was that?
That was in Germany.
Oh, Germany, 1968.
Yes.
Nice.
Because Germany's always been known for their politics. I don't know.
There we go.
As Dominic searches through the record vaults.
Yeah,
so we got for some goodies.
Yeah, we should play this because this is important stuff.
Get people in the mood for Tuesday.
Yeah, get people in the mood for Tuesday. So, you know, let me reach over here and cue this up. Is Cream's "Politician" is from their Farewell concert, the last one at Royal Albert Hall in 2005. Of course. Politician is, as my saying goes, politics is a legalized form of organized crime. On FM 88, WMUC. What happened to it? I don't know. What happened? Oh, look at that. I put the wrong button. Sometimes this finger just doesn't really work well. Let's try that again. What station is it?
Something MU something WMUC. There's an orgasm in there somewhere.
College Park, right?
Yeah. Pretty sure we're somewhere around the 88.1 on the dial mark.
I see you rounded it off there a little bit.
Yeah, well, it's, I don't know if it's 88.15, 88.12, 88.1. Yeah, I'll just say 88.1.
That works.
There we go.
Okay.
To my big black car. Hey now, baby, get into my big black car. Wanna just show you what my politics are. A simple lead, though I'm leaning to the right. A simple lead, yes, though I'm leaning to the right. I'm just not there. Come into it, fight.
88.1 WMUC-FM, reminding you to get out and vote, will you please? And also turn your clocks back. Eric Clapton on the guitar. There we are. And or as a reminder to set your clocks back tonight at 2 a.m., it becomes 1 a.m. Or you can set them back wherever you like. Start off with a little bit of 13th floor elevators. She lives in a time of her own.
She lives, no fear, doubtless in everything she knows. Her mind unchecked, the sureness of her foes. She leaves herself inside you when she goes. You have always heard her speaking.
missing you now, and the future's unknown. I'm determined to hang on to this world to see. I try to do it just right, but I've got a burning question.
FM 88, WMUC-FM, College Park. Dominic with you here and hanging out on a beautiful Saturday afternoon. Get outside, take your radio with you so you can stay tuned. And at the bottom of the set, the a suite by Speed Limit 35, members of which, including Steve Rabler, formed the band Blue Wave Theory. So it's originated out of both these bands, Speed Limit 35 and Blue Wave Theory, both originated out of the New York, New Jersey area. So there is great surf music on the East Coast, as well as this very nice progressive, and this was kind of a mixture, progressive, ethereal. It's hard to pen, but if you get a chance to get your hands on this album, I really suggest it. Speed Limit 35, the album is called Shifting Gears, and we heard the Mechanical Failure Suite, which is Abort, Reboot, Execute from Speed Limit 35. I'm a little behind on my playlist, so I'm trying to memorize some stuff. Get the timing before that. We're falling back this evening. Spring forward, fall back. So the hour you lost in the spring, you'll get it back tonight. Or actually early tomorrow morning. Get the timing from Black Fortress of Opium, their album Stratospherical, and Nick Riff from one of his latest releases called Photon Shift with Edge of Time, and 13th Floor Elevator is a really great tune that they did called, composed by Rocky Erickson, She Lives in a Time of Her Own, from the album Easter Everywhere. And of course, starting us off, To My Friend, from the album Climbing by Mountain, the Electric Candle theme song. In the background, Jaguar God from my namesake, Dominic Frontiere. I think I said that right. From his album, Pagan Festival, An Exotic Love Ritual for Orchestra. There we go. Up next, get into a couple of little pop songs, which is always fitting for this time of year. FM 88. WMUC-FM, College Park. No, I won't torture you too much with, like, Donny Osmond or anything. Don't start to get nervous, okay? Thanks.
There's something special at 6 o'clock in the morning when it's still too early to know, and the dusky light shines down on the block and reflects up and down on the hands of the clock.
o'clock, 6 o'clock, 6 o'clock. A few hours ago she was standing here, just watching the stars in our eyes and the lights as the tides disappear. And I could feel I could say what I want, that I could nudge her and call her my confidant.
You know, I got to try and get that buzz out of there. I don't know what that buzz is. Oh, man. Not happy with that. Let's give this one other. Okay, let me make a slight adjustment. Bear with me. Bear with me. Love and Spoonful. FM 88. WMUC.
There's something special about 6 o'clock in the morning when it's still too early to knock, and the dusty light shines down on the block and reflects up and down on the hands of the clock. 6 o'clock, 6 o'clock. A few hours ago she was standing here, just watching the stars in our eyes and the lights as the tides disappear. And I could feel I could say what I want, that I could nudge her and call her my confidant. And now I'm back alone with just my shadow in front. At 6 o'clock, 6 o'clock, I went home and found that trying to sleep wasn't there, just watching my eyelids, knowing my brain bids the night not to pass. I got up and got scuffling around, but somehow it just wasn't the same happy town. And the bells didn't ring with the same happy sound. 6 o'clock, 6 o'clock. If I go back where we parted, would I ever feel like that again? Guess I'll just have to wait till tomorrow. But what can I do till then? Guess I'll go back home and just wait until dawn. Guess I had to learn going back where we were wouldn't help at all. And I wish my head had been working right. We'd have gone for coffee and talked all night. Now I'm back alone, being twisted up tight. 6 o'clock, 6 o'clock. Now I'm back.
You ask for it. Sometimes I will, then again I think I won't. Sometimes I do, then again I think I don't. I looked at my watch and it was 12:45. I said, come on, baby, and let's have us some fun. And we reeled. It was 1:45. You know she said she didn't, but I know she do. And we reeled. We were reeling, rocking and rolling, child. Reeling and rocking, rolling till the break of. Looked at my watch and it was 2:45. She said, wait a minute, Chuck, I gotta go take a, give me a Coca-Cola over there, please. Reeling and rocking and rolling, child. Reeling and rocking, rolling till the break of dawn. watching it was quarter to four. You know she didn't even wait 3 minutes. Say, give me some more when I read. Watching it was quarter to five, rolling like a Mercedes on a 4-day drive, man. We were reeling and rocking and rolling till the break of. Looked at my watch and it was quarter to six. Took a little time, but I finally got it fixed, and I reeled. Watching it was way past six. I jumped back firm like a cement mix, man. I'm reeling, rocking, reeling, rocking. We're reeling and rocking, rolling till the break of dawn. Looked at my watch and it was a little past seven. That's when we rolled up and took off to heaven. Watching it was quarter past eight. She made a little move and made me stretch out straight. Yeah, hey, hey, hey. We were reeling, rocking and rolling, child. Reeling and rocking, rolling till the break of dawn. Looked at my watch and it was quarter past nine. She said, "Ooh, Chuck, baby, this show feel fine." I was. Watching it was something to ten. She called me right back and made me do it again. And I was rocking and reeling and rolling, child. Reeling and rocking, rolling till the break of dawn. Looked at my watch and it was 11:30. She turned around, called me something dirty. You know why? You know why? Looked at my watch and it was straight up 12. Man, we started. started digging like an old steam shovel. We were reading, rocking, we were rolling, we were reading, we were reeling, rocking and rolling till the break of dawn. We did it in the kitchen, we did it in the hall. I got some on my finger, but I wiped it on the wall.
Early in the morning. got nothing, no nothing but the blues. I went to your girlfriend's house, but she was out. I knocked on your daddy's door, but he began to shout, and he said it's early in the morning. Don't you know it's early in the morning? Early in the morning, I ain't got nothing, no nothing but the blues. I went to Doobie Chase to get something to eat. The waitress looked at me, she said, Harry, you sure look beat. Don't you know it's early in the morning? Early in the morning, 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 early in the morning.
6 o'clock in the morning. I could see it was dawn, and you gone, you
FM 88 at WMUC FM in College Park. At the bottom of the set, we heard from the Feminine Complex, one of the earliest all-female bands from the late 60s, from their album Live in Love, with 6 o'clock in the morning. In the morning, we'll go to midnight, coming up pretty soon, too. Before the Dawn, from Jaco Gardner's latest release, Hypnophobia. Released just last year. And Early in the Morning, from Harry Nielsen's release, Nielsen Schmielsen, by request for Sandy in Baltimore, Maryland. Tuned in on the internet, and you can too, at WMUCRadio.org. Time of the Season, from the Zombies, Odyssey and Oracle release, which was also a big single for them. And from his live appearance in London in 1972, Chuck Berry with Reelin' and Rockin'. And, of course, Chicago, back when you were a great band. Chicago Transit Authority, the name of the name of the group, originally. Does anybody really know what time it is? And of course, you know, since the Cubs won, we're going to close off the show with a couple of things for the Cubs' victory in the World Series. 6 o'clock started that set off from the Lovin' Spoonful, their album Everything Playing. That was also a big single for them. 301-314-8800 is the number up at the studio. Dominic with you here until 6 p.m. Dave comes in to bring you Dave's record collection. We're going to start off the next set the way I used to start off my Wednesday morning show from 9 to noon back in the previous century. You dig in the background from James Gang's album Funk number 49. It was very aptly put by the field marshal, who said this is like the perfect 3 in the morning coffee and cigarette song. And we'll start off with the original Electric Candle theme song opener, first by Jim Morrison.
Is everybody in? Is everybody in? Is everybody in? The ceremony is about to begin.
Yeah. Did you see me drop the bed low? Oh yeah.
Got to go. So if you listen for the music.
catch me, no. Not gonna let them catch the midnight ride.
Feel like this. Thank you.
Thank you.
FM 88, WMUC-FM, College Park. Dominic with you here, hanging around on a beautiful Saturday afternoon. A little on the cool side, but get outside, take your radio with you so you can tune in and soak up some of what's left of the sunshine for today. In the background, All India Radio from their album Echo Other. We're falling back this afternoon at 2 a.m. Set your clocks back to 1 a.m. This track is called The Time. And before that, Alone at Midnight from the Smithereens, their first album called Especially for You. And preceded by Midnight Rider and Soulshine from the Allman Brothers release Live at the Beacon Theater in 2003. And another show in New York, live at the Madison Square Garden in also in 2003. The Rolling Stones gave us Midnight Rambler and Cream from Klook's Kleek, the performance live at Klook's Kleek in London in November 15th of 1966, some 50 years ago, with Hey Lordy Mama by Cream. And Midnight Man, also from the Beacon Theater, recorded in 2006. The James Gang gave us Midnight Man. And It's Not My Place in the 9-to-5 World by the Ramones from the album Pleasant Dreams. And starting that set, a little excerpt from the track called Awake from Jim Morrison's album American Prayer. 301-314-8800 is the number up at the studio. Dominic with you here for about another 15 minutes. Then we're going to cram in a couple of more time songs and give a little nod to the Cubs as well. Stick around. FM 88, WMUC. This is Electric Candle Radio.
told you when to run. You missed the starting gun.
Dukes declare it's 25 o'clock. 88.1 WMUC-FM, College Park.
Each watch I smash apart. listen anyway. Time has come today. Yeah.
wounded by the sun. But I had my fun. I've been loved and put aside. I've been crushed by tumbling tide. And my soul has been psychedelicized. Now the time has come. There are things to realize. Time has come today.
.1 WMUC-FM, College Park. All right. FM 88 is WMUC-FM College Park. Dominic with you here. Been a pleasure to sit in with you and give you Electric Candle Radio. We got a few items to wrap up, and we're going to do this between my show and Dave's because, you know, of course, the Cubs, speaking of time, after 108 years, the Cubs have finally won the World Series. But the bottom of the set, of course, in the background now is the Strawberry Alarm Clock. Do I have it? There we go.
It's called Unwind the Clock.
Yeah. I'm just trying to get my playlist to update, and it's not updating.
Oh, man.
I don't know why. Oh, well, there we go. We'll try it again. I'm One of the Clock from Strawberry Alarm Clock's album Incense and Peppermints. And at the bottom of the set, Harry Nilsson from his album A Touch of Schmielsen in the Night, where he covered a bunch of older show tunes with As Time Goes By. Time Has Come Today from the Chambers Brothers release Time Has Come. And the Dukes, we're going to put it at the Dukes of Stratosphere, the alter ego band of XTC. From their album 25 O'Clock, the title track. Time from Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon, and started that set off with the previous talk over, All India Radio, with The Time from their album Echo Other. And Dave's here to take good care of you with Dave's record collection, and we got the Cubs are like made history. You know, it'd be nice. It's great to see that happen in, you know, at least in our lifetime, right?
That's right, and the guy we're going to tribute here was a huge Cubs fan and wrote what turned out to be an anthem for the Cubs. It's a lasting anthem. It was played at this celebration, Go Cubs Go. And he also wrote a thing called A Dying Cub Fan's Last Request. And, you know, it's not going to be as appropriate anymore, but it certainly expresses the years of frustration.
That's for sure.
And generations of frustration.
Yeah, so actually what I've got lined up is, I guess, pretty much in that order. The A Dying Cub Fan's Last Request, Take Me Out to the Ball Game, and Go Cubs Go from a live album he did called No Big Surprise. I'm sure you've got this one, too.
Yeah, actually, it's a...
The two-disc set,
it's
right?
half live and half studio.
Oh, is it? Is it? Yeah. Is it? Disc two is all live, and disc one is all studio.
Yeah.
Okay.
And a good collection of what he did in his lifetime. Kind of a great retrospective. No Big Surprise is a great retrospective of the late great Steve Goodman.
And this was released posthumously, wasn't it?
Yes.
Okay.
He died in 1984 at the age of 36 of leukemia. And not long after he wrote that song, A Dying Cub Fan's Last Request.
I wonder if he had some inkling of what was going on.
I think, sadly, yes.
Yeah, unfortunately. And I'd always heard it, but I wasn't really entirely sure if it was all of his ashes or some of his ashes. Some of his ashes are spread, actually, in Wrigley Field.
I don't know. The song does allude to that, but I don't know if that actually happened or not.
Yeah, I thought it was all of them, but it's actually some of his ashes were spread at Wrigley's Field, and then the family, I'm not sure what they did, but of course, then they had their own interment. But it was nice. So you know, he was there to witness it. Well, although it was in Cleveland, but he was at least at Wrigley Field, so. with 5 million people gathered around outside. So
here's to all the Cub fans, the Cubs, and baseball, and Steve Goodman. We love you, Steve. We loved you, and we still love you.
Absolutely. And congratulations, a big congratulations to the Cubs. Oh, one of the sportscasters, I don't know if you heard it, he said, like, I think it was like after the game was over, he was making some commentary, and he said it was like the game seven was like a heart attack every 5 minutes.
It was an incredible game.
It was an incredible series. I think this had to be the best World Series I've ever seen.
And if you just want to take Game 7 out of that, I mean, just one thing after another, my gosh.
I know. Overtime, and it rains. They're ahead, and they're behind, and they're to tie it, and then it rains. And it is like,
I was definitely ready for bed.
Yeah, really. And, you know, a big congratulation, and also to all of our many, many listeners in Chicago, Illinois. Congratulations. Did you see anything on the parade? Like 5 million people showed up.
Yeah,
for the parade.
Incredible.
It's nuts. They had some aerial shots, and the crowd was just absolutely massive.
Yeah, my youngest son flew out Wednesday.
Oh, TJ?
Flew out Wednesday night.
That's right. John's living there, right?
As the game was going on, of course, the game was going on in Cleveland, but of course, everybody was watching in Chicago, and he says, "I hope I get out of here before the riot starts."
Well, I haven't heard of anything bad happening, so that's
good. Yeah, that's always good.
That's a good thing, definitely. You're going to do a bunch of stuff on time, and you know, and
yeah,
some,
time
and some
as
more
well
Steve Goodman
this evening,
stuff.
And yeah, it's going to be all about time because we're springing forward. No, we're falling
back. Spring
forward.
We already
fall did back. That.
We already sprang forwards. We're falling back. So, spring forward, fall back.
So turn your clock back. 1 hour, 2 o'clock this morning.
So it would become 1 a.m. Or you could wait till 6 a.m. Or you could do it now.
You could do it now if you want.
Yeah. Or you can get up at 2 a.m., turn it back to 1, and then get up at 4 a.m., turn it forward 2 hours, and then get up at 5 a.m. and turn it back 2 hours. And I think you'll be right.
Yeah, that would work.
Something like that, right?
Yeah.
We're right back where we started. All right. And that's it. We'll close out the show and begin Dave's show. We'll overlap here a little bit with the three Steve Goodman pieces from the album No Big Surprise on 88.1 WMUC-FM in the most beautiful, wonderful downtown
College Park,
the cultural mecca of Prince George's County. Have a great weekend, everyone, and a great next week. I'll see you again next Saturday afternoon for Electric Candle Radio, 3 p.m. Stick around for Dave. Dave's Record Collection. Take good care of you till 10 o'clock. Steve Goodman on FM 88, WMUC.
By the shores of old Lake Michigan, where the hawk wind blows so cold, an old Cub fan lay dying in his midnight hour, the toll. Round his bed his friends had all gathered. They knew his time was short. On his head they put this bright blue cap from his all-time favorite sport. He told him, "It's late, it's getting dark in here, and I know it's time to go. But before I leave the lineup, boys, there's just one thing that I'd like to know. Do they still play the blues in Chicago when baseball season rolls around? When the snow melts away, do the Cubbies still play in their ivy-covered burial ground? When I was a boy, they were my pride and joy, but now they only bring fatigue to the home of the brave, the land of the free, and the the doormat of the National League. He told his friends, you know the law of averages says anything will happen that can. That's what it says. But the last time the Cubs won a National League pennant was the year we dropped the bomb on Japan.